Hi guys, today I want to show you a little bit more about texture and how I use the texture brushes that I have. Basically, I want to show you simple rendering with texture brushes and how I approach it, because there's a different way, I guess, to approach it. And I want to show you my technique because I feel like it's the easiest way to actually learn it. So basically here, I just have two circles, and I want to first, on the first circle, I want to show you what would be the most simple way to actually make a sphere out of this. So the easiest way to do this would be to actually use a round, soft round brush like this. And basically I would paint the whole circle in black and then use some gray and just use the brush to actually make the rendering of it and make it look like it's a sphere. And just with the same brush like this, I would be able to make it look like a sphere. And then if I wanted to have an hard edge brush to just add a little spot where it's look a little bit more sparkly like this, I would be able to do it. But when it comes to texture brushes, it's the same kind of thing, it's the same kind of thinking. You need to have a soft brush and an hard edge brush. So what I would do here is here I prepare you a selection of the texture brushes that I like to use. The first one are hard edge brush, and the three last one are a little bit more soft. Basically, you can use any of those brushes, and I'll just give you a demonstration here. And the way it works is I would probably paint just a simple rendering like this, and just be really, really, real fast on it, and just use the hard edge brush like this. And then I would use a softer brush, but something with texture. So this one has texture in it, and just start to render the edges of it. And it's gonna give me a result as a sphere, but it's not perfectly round like this one here. It's just gonna render the edges like this. And obviously it's gonna take more time, a little bit more sampling too. So you see I'm picking colors, values actually, here and there to just start rendering it. And slowly, what I'm doing is I'm painting over all the edges that I just created, but at the same time, I make it more round. And now at this point, it's up to you to decide when it's rendered enough for you. In my case, I could actually say that this is render enough. It's not perfectly round. And if I wanted to add a little spot, I could actually take a hard edge brush and then just add a little spot of shininess here. So that's how I use the hard edge brushes and the soft brushes with texture. So that's really an easy exercise. And if you want, you can download this PSD below this video and take the brushes and install them as well. But I'm not gonna stop here. I'm actually gonna show you how I would approach the whole thing on a portrait. So here I have a simple outline of this guy. And I'll give you the link so you can actually go download this picture if you wanna try this. And basically what I need to start here beside this outline is a marquee all around it, and here I have it already. You can create it with either the lasso tool, the polygon one works well, or you can take the pen tool. As long as we have a marquee, it's gonna help you. And what I'll do first is create a new layer under the lines, and I'll first fill it up with some gray. In this case, I'll take something a little bit more pale. And then what I'll use is the texture brush, which looks a little bit more like a soft edge brush, and I'll start my basic rendering. So it's gonna start by just adding a little bit more of the rendering, but with some texture at the beginning. And so at this point I'm going very loose. I'm not worried about any details. I'm just painting with my texture brush over the places that I see that it's darker. So I can see that under the nose here, a little bit here, and all those places. And for those for that kind of start, you want to start from actually far away a little bit, just to be able to see all the different values everywhere. And I won't do the clothing right now, but here, just a little bit maybe. Basically, you want to just add some texture and some rendering at the same time. And once the first rendering like this is going to be placed, I will then paint but on top of my lines to make sure to make them disappear slowly. So right now it's just a matter of adding a little bit more shadow here and there. And I think that from here, I will start paint on top of the line. So I'm going to create a new layer on top of the line, and there I'll just go a little bit closer. And to help me, I will also just put my line a little bit less, a little bit more transparent, and like let's say around 50%. From here, it's going to be easier. And from here is the same thing that I did with the circle. So basically, I'm going to take an art edge brush, and I'm going to start to render, starting by painting. See the eyelid here, and I'm just gonna paint like this. When I want to make a transition, then I'm gonna take a softer brush, but something with some texture, and just create that transition. And then I'll go back to an art edge brush and just continue painting. It's a technique that just requires a little bit more patience. And from here, it's basically the same thing that I'll do over and over again. Just trying to render with one brush, then switch to something softer if I want to have a softer transition, but still with something with texture. So I'm going to do that for the next few minutes. And I'll stop a little bit later to show you a little bit more details. Okay, so from here, I feel like I have like the basic rendering done. And as you can see, there's like rough parts a little bit everywhere. And at this point, what I'm gonna do is just go a little bit more in details. I'm still going to use the same kind of brushes, so art edge and softer edge, but with texture, but I'm just going to go more in details. So I'm going to start probably with the eyes and just walk around everywhere and try to render it to a point that I feel comfortable with it. So there you go. There's a little bit more detail here. And as you can see, I've been using only the same kind of brushes, so the art edge brushes and the softer but brushes with texture, but the soft edge brushes to render a little bit more. And at this point, I feel like this study is pretty much already done. Obviously, it's up to me to just add more time and more detail to it, but I think at this stage, it's pretty much done. So here you go. If you want to have the set of brushes that I've been using for this tutorial, you can download them at the bottom of this video. I will also give you a link where you can actually see this picture online. And from there, you can actually give it a try. And that's it for this tutorial. So I hope that you find this helpful. And as usual, happy painting.